and Dave Need Wedding Dates. It's directed by Jake Szymanski. It stars Zac Efron, Aubrey Plaza, Anna Kendrick, and Adam Devine. And it's a story about these two knuckleheads, these two goof-offs. All they love to do is party and chase girls and smoke weed and drink and all of that shit. One day, their parents come down to them and let them know that their sister is getting married, and they would like them to be at the wedding. They want them to have dates at the wedding. They want them to get nice, smart, sensible girls and bring them to the wedding to impress them. They go off to find dates. These two girls hatch this scheme to get a free trip to Hawaii, essentially. And there's your movie. Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates. They get two wedding dates. They all go to Hawaii, and hilarity ensues. Guys, let's talk about this movie, and let's try to do it without laughing. This movie is fucking hilarious. I was laughing my ass off throughout this entire movie. This movie was relentlessly entertaining, guys. I gotta say, and I came into this movie with minimal to no expectations. I wasn't really expecting a great movie. I saw the trailer. It looked kind of funny. I thought I'd check it out. I got an early screening for it, and this movie was awesome. Zac Efron was really funny. And you know what? The more I see Zac Efron, the more I'm just convinced that he's just one of the funniest guys working in Hollywood. It seems like everything I see him in nowadays is comedic gold, because he was comedic gold in this movie. At this point, every single movie that Zac Efron is in, I'm just convinced there's going to be a whole bunch of funny shit in it, and he is going to be the biggest reason why. Adam Devine, his brother, is in the movie. They have terrific chemistry, and Adam Devine, hands down, might be the most hilarious person in this movie. Literally, my stomach was hurting from some of the shit that I saw him do in this movie. They play off of each other really well. They have great comedic timing, and they really do carry the movie with a lot. They're both really charismatic, really energetic, and that's a great thing that this movie has going for it, is it has a lot of great energy to it. And the two chicks, Aubrey Plaza and Anna Kendricks. Now, normally I would think that maybe, you know, it would have become the Zac Efron, Adam Devine show, and they would have just felt like whatever characters. No, they're fucking hilarious too. In fact, they damn near steal the movie from the guys. They were like two of the funniest chicks that I've ever seen in my life. What I loved about all of these characters was the way that they fit together, the way that they all complemented each other. And I loved how they're all kind of like reflections of each other. Like, one of them is this immature screw-up who thinks he'll never amount to something, so he hides his pain behind laughs. Another one hides her insecurities behind confidence and an overwhelming sense of, oh, I'm awesome, but in fact she feels like she can't accomplish anything. The other character, he wants to branch out on his own, and he wants to become his own person, but too scared to do it. And then there's another person who's going through something really tragic and traumatic, and it really messes them up. And I love how they're all kind of like cracked reflections of each other. There's a lot of this comedy in this movie, guys, that just feels like it was ad-libbed. It feels like it was just made up on the fly. It feels like they weren't even reading a script. It looks like they looked at the script and then looked at how well these actors played together, and then they were just like, script? Who needs that shit? Hey, let's just film them doing funny shit. Almost every single scene in this movie, I was laughing. There was always something new, something to get my attention. The humor is over the top, it's raunchy, so there's some shock value, but also some of the humor is actually pretty clever. Some of the dialogue in this movie, the comedic dialogue, was really good. This movie consistently kept my stomach and my face hurting throughout the entire movie. I had to pee for the last hour. I did not want to fucking get up. That's how funny this movie is. Gripes with the movie. I mean, the movie's a bit predictable. You kind of have seen this thing in comedies before. You've seen it in other movies. You kind of know what you're getting. The movie has some things that are cliched about it. It's kind of predictable at some points, but I can honestly say throughout this movie, I was not bored. The only real thing I can say about this movie is that you've seen the premise and you've seen something like this a lot of times before. I had a blast watching this movie. I went in with no expectations. It surprised the hell out of me. Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates, and apparently Mike and Dave need the rating of Man of Steel. Guys, this movie was fucking awesome sauce. Go check it out. You're going to love it. You're going to be entertained. I can guarantee it. It doesn't come out this week. It comes out next week. Next week, July 8th. Go give this movie your money. Don't give it to Independence Day. Fuck Independence Day. Please go see this movie next week when it comes out, and you're going to have a good time. Thank you guys so much for watching my review of Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates. Stay tuned. I'll have a review for Legend of Tarzan up tomorrow. Thank you guys so much. And if you like what you see, tell me how you feel. And stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Peace.